Have you been looking to get started building with artificial intelligence and machine learning, but you just don't know where to get started? What if you could do all of that without writing even a single line of code? If you're already interested, then this video series is for you. My name is Brian Huff. I am a full stack software engineer and also an AWS community builder. And I'm going to be walking through a very exciting stock price prediction project. As I was scrolling through the AWS community forum, I found this post written by Victoria Seaman from AWS, and she walks through how to predict the price of a stock into the future based upon its previous history. And I thought that that was really cool, and I was also very interested and skeptical because she said that she didn't use any code to go through it. So if you're already interested, I was interested, then you're going to definitely want to watch these series of videos. So what we're going to do is we're going to be using a few core AWS services, including Amazon S3 for storing our data. We're going to use a publicly accessible data set from NASDAQ. We're going to be using Amazon SageMaker Canvas to use our ML model to then predict the data. And then we're going to be visualizing a lot of this data in Amazon QuickSight for a very nice dashboard. So with that, if you're already interested in this, then you're definitely going to want to stay tuned for this series of videos where we'll build all this together. So if you're excited, let's get started. If you scroll over to the community.aws/tutorials, you'll see no code AI with SageMaker Canvas. So let's just go through a couple of the pieces here. So what we're going to be doing is that we're going to be taking a low code approach to using SageMaker with a service like Canvas. So, and of course, it also goes without saying that this is 100% not meant for investment purposes or financial advice. This is just showcasing how data can be used to potentially predict future data that could happen, a month from now, a couple months from now, a year from now. But this isn't, you know, not financial advice by any means. So what we're going to be doing is that we're going to be taking the history of stock prices and then basically try or attempt to see how the price could change based upon certain behaviors that have happened previously. Now, obviously, past performance doesn't equal future returns. You know, you hear that in finance all the time, or investing, if you've, you know, ever invested on, you know, certain apps or on websites. But obviously, this is not for financial decision making. This is just for trying to understand how we could use data from data sets to then model how stocks have previously performed and then see outcomes. So we're going to be going through four specific steps. So part one is configuring some presets, prerequisites, and setups so that we can utilize our data set in AWS. We're then going to be building predictions with SageMaker Canvas. Then in part three, we're going to be using a specific model to generate those predictions from the data that we've generated. And then in the last step, we're going to be creating a visualization dashboard with QuickSight to see those predictions and what we made. So here's a little bit of the architecture that Victoria created for us. So there's basically four parts here. So we're going to be taking historical data from NASDAQ. NASDAQ has a lot of data being that they are at the center of financial investments. So they have a lot of data, and some of that data is public, and we're able to actually use that as our data set. We also are going to then modify that data set and then upload it to an S3 bucket in AWS, which is right here. Then in part three, we're going to be using SageMaker Canvas to then build a model, that low code, no code implementation of AI at SageMaker. And then we're going to visualize those forecasted data sets using QuickSight. And that's how we're going to wrap up all of our information and then make it in a nice visual way to understand it. So those are really the four parts here. And with this architecture diagram, we'll be able to really create a robust AI pipeline that can process data, clean data, analyze data, and then visualize data. So these are going to be the four steps that we'll be going through in the next series of videos. All right, that was a lot of information that we just walked through. So let's digest it all and see where we're going. So the first step that we walked through was understanding the scope of this project. We're going to be trying to predict the price of a stock based upon historical data that's accessible to us from NASDAQ. And we're going to be using Amazon SageMaker Canvas to do that. So the way that we're implementing this is we're taking our data from our publicly accessible data set. We're then going to be storing that data in Amazon S3. Amazon S3 is then going to be piping that data into Amazon SageMaker Canvas. And then SageMaker Canvas is going to be able to let us port that out to Amazon QuickSight to then visualize that data set. So what we're going to be doing over the next series of videos is helping you set up your SageMaker domain to then get started using Canvas, and also see how we can take our data set from NASDAQ and then start putting that into the cloud and start working with it. So if you're excited for this next series of videos, you're definitely going to want to stay tuned for this next set where we'll get you set up to build with AI and ML. Looking forward to building alongside you. So I'll see you in the next series of videos.